गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट जियोमेट्रिकल मीनिंग ऑफ अ पॉलीनोमियल। इन दैट टॉपिक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी व्हाट इज अ जियोमेट्रिकल मीनिंग ऑफ लीनियर पॉलीनोमियल एंड सेकेंड वीडियो we have seen what is the geometrical meaning of quadratic polynomial. Today I talk about geometrical meaning of cubic polynomial. Without wasting time, let's start. Look here everyone. Standard tag मैथमेटिक्स सेकेंड चैप्टर पॉलीनोमियल टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट क्यूबिक पॉलीनोमियल एंड ड्रॉ अ ग्राफ ऑफ अ क्यूबिक पॉलीनोमियल एंड फाइंड जीरोस ऑफ अ क्यूबिक पॉलीनोमियल। आवर टॉपिक इज कंटिन्यूइंग जीरोस ऑफ गिवन पॉलीनोमियल। एज वी नो दैट द ग्राफ ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस is always gives us straight line. First of all, we recall linear polynomial gives us straight line and quadratic polynomial look like open upwards or down upwards like this. It called parabolas, like parabolas. And today we learn about cubic polynomial. How look like a graph of a cubic polynomial? Keep in your mind, sometimes in a final exam, examiner asks us in a MCQ as well as true or false. Okay, now take some cubic polynomial. Let's suppose we have px is equal to x cube minus 4x. This is a cubic polynomial. Why it's a cubic polynomial? Because the degree of this polynomial is 3. Therefore, this is a cubic polynomial. Now, we obtain some value of y corresponding value of x. Suppose we take x is equal to minus 2, then what happened? Put x is equal to minus 2 in this polynomial. We have, suppose this is a y, y is equal to x cube minus 4x. If we put x is equal to minus 2, then what happened? Minus 2 cube minus 8 minus 8. Okay, here our polynomial is x cube minus 4x. Put value of x. X is equal to minus 2. Therefore, minus 8 plus 8, we have 0. Corresponding value of y is equal to 0. Now take another value. Suppose minus 1, we take x is equal to minus 1. what happen? X cube minus 4x, s is equal to minus 1. Again, value of x is equal to minus 1. We have minus 1 plus 4, that means 3. Value of y, we get 3. Now, take 0. Then what happens? Our polynomial is x cube minus 4x. Value of x is equal to 0. This time, we have 0 minus 0, 0. Okay? Now take value of x is equal to 1. You take any value of x. Y is equal to x cube minus 4x. X is equal to, this time we have 1. Therefore 1 minus 4, that means minus 3. And last value, suppose we take 2, x is equal to 2. We calculate here, y is equal to x cube minus 4x. Value of x is equal to 2. 2 cube minus 2, that means 8 minus 8, therefore 0. Corresponding value of y is equal to 0. Therefore, our points are minus 2, 0, minus 1, 3, 0, 0, 1, minus 3, 2, 0. Now we plot all these points on a graph paper and see what happened and its graph, how look like. Suppose I sketch a rough sketch, graph paper. Suppose this is a x-axis and this is a y-axis. Now what is a maximum positive number? 2. This is a origin 1, 2. Maximum negative number is also minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2. Maximum positive value of y is 3. Therefore, I write 1, 2, 3. Minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. Our point is, first point is minus 2, 0. Minus 2, 0. That means this point. Second point, minus 1, 3. Minus 1 and 3. That means here. Suppose intersection of minus 1 and 3 is here. 0, 0. That means this is your origin, 0, 0. 1 minus 3. That means 1 minus 3. Suppose it's a here. 2, 0. Our last point is 2, 0. That means if we join all these points in order, we have shape like this is a graph of a cubic polynomial x cube minus 4x. Now how many times this graph is intersect on x-axis? There is a 3 intersection point, 1, 2 and 3. Therefore, 3 zeros of these polynomials. If we ask how many zeros of this polynomial, we say that 3 zeros of this polynomial. Therefore, we write here, px x cube minus 4x have 3 zeros. Cubic polynomial has always 3 zeros. We cannot say that, but we say that cubic polynomial has at most 3 zeros. In our previous video, we discussed about a quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial have at most 2 zero. Here cubic polynomial have at most 3 zero. That means it have no zero, it have single zero, it have 2 zero or it have 3 zeros. Now take some more example and we find zeros of a given polynomial. I draw some graph sketch here and find zeros of a polynomial. Find zeros. Simply just. Suppose we have graph, this type of graph, like this. Second graph. Like this. Third one is suppose fourth one is okay. Take some more examples. Fifth. Like this. Suppose six one. Okay, see here. In this first example, intersection of straight line and x-axis gives us single point. That means zeros of this graph is only one zeros. In a second example, intersection of our graph and x-axis is two points. Therefore, here this graph have two zeros. Here this graph have one zeros. In an example 3, how many times intersect graph with x-axis? So here we count, only keep in your mind, only we see x-axis, not a y-axis. Here 1, 2 and 3. Therefore, this graph have a 3 zeros. Similar way, here intersection with x-axis is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore, this graph have a 4 zeros. Look at that. Here, only one intersection origin. Therefore, here single zero. That means this graph have 1 zeros. Similar way, here intersection of with x-axis, there are two points. That means this graph have two zeros. And finally, here also intersection with x-axis, 1 and 2. Also here this graph is having two zeros. Okay, this all about how we find zeros with help of given graph. In our textbook, exercise 2.1, similar type of this graph, and we find how many zeros of given graph. I hope all students are understood very clearly. Okay, take care, have a nice day, and thank you very much.